During Operation Sindoor, approximately 15 BrahMos missiles, launched from Su-30 MKI fighters and ground platforms, struck Pakistani Air Force bases, causing significant damage to runways, command centers, and radar sites. None of the missiles were intercepted. For example, Nur Khan Air Base, which is located in Rawalpindi, adjacent to the capital city of Islamabad, holding immense strategic significance for Pakistan's military, was struck by BrahMos, even though the Chinese-origin HQ-9P air defense system was stationed there. While BrahMos is a pretty impressive weapon, another weapon with far more lethality is taking shape. India has reportedly conducted a test of a new hypersonic missile capable of reaching speeds up to Mach 8, 8 times the speed of sound, and striking targets at distances of up to 1,500 kilometers, approximately 930 miles. Known as the Extended Trajectory Long Duration Hypersonic Cruise Missile, ET-LDHCM, the weapon is being developed under the Defense Research and Development Organization's DRDO Project Vishnu. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how ET-LDHCM will boost India's deterrence. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. An object is considered hypersonic when it travels at speeds greater than Mach 5, 5 times the speed of sound. This equates to approximately 1,715 meters per second, 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. The breakneck speed of hypersonic weapons and the ability to fly in erratic paths give them a much higher probability of penetrating modern air defenses. They are very hard to track, let alone intercept. It's important to note that while traditional ballistic missiles also achieve hypersonic speeds during their terminal descent, they travel along relatively predictable parabolic trajectories. This predictability allows anti-ballistic missile defense systems a window of opportunity to detect, track, and intercept them. Hypersonic weapons are mainly of three types: air-launched ballistic missile, ALBM, hypersonic glide body, HGV, and hypersonic cruise missiles, HCM, which is what ET-LDHCM is. ALBM goes ballistic seconds after it has been launched from an aircraft, unlike traditional subsonic cruise missiles, which are mostly powered by turbofan engines. Russian Kinjal missile, which has been used in Ukraine, is an example of this type. HGV is launched to extremely high altitudes using a carrier missile. It then detaches itself and glides back, attaining a hypersonic speed. Russian Avangard and China's DFZF are examples of this type. Hypersonic cruise missiles initially accelerate to hypersonic speeds using a rocket booster and then switch to an air-breathing scramjet engine that keeps them powered throughout their flight. Zircon, designated 3M-22 by the Russian Navy, deployed in 2023, is the only known operational missile of this type in the world. Admiral Gorshkov-class frigates were the first to receive this missile. The U.S. is working on several scramjet-powered platforms like the Hypersonic Attack Cruise Missile, HACM. The ETL-DHCM is powered by a scramjet engine that uses air-breathing propulsion, relying on atmospheric oxygen rather than a traditional rotating compressor. This allows the missile to reach Mach 8. A scramjet, short for supersonic combustion ramjet, is an advanced type of air-breathing engine designed to operate at hypersonic speeds. Unlike traditional jet engines or rockets, a scramjet uses the high speed of the vehicle to compress incoming air, allowing combustion to take place at supersonic speeds without any moving parts. Scramjets are a variant of ramjet engines, which themselves rely on vehicle speed rather than mechanical compressors to compress incoming air. In a conventional ramjet, the incoming air slows to subsonic speeds before combustion. A scramjet, however, allows the air to remain supersonic throughout the entire engine, hence supersonic combustion ramjet. In this context, viewers may also note that BrahMos uses a ramjet engine. It is also to be remembered here that on April 25th, the Defense Research and Development Organization reached a major milestone by successfully conducting a scramjet combustor ground test lasting over 1,000 seconds at the Scramjet Connect test facility in Hyderabad. This test, the longest known scramjet engine run to date, represented a significant breakthrough and seems to be a precursor to this latest test. ET-LDHCM is engineered to handle extreme thermal stress, with performance stability maintained at temperatures up to 2,000 degrees Celsius during hypersonic travel. This capability is critical for sustained speed and accuracy. It can carry a payload of up to 2,000 kilograms or about 4,410 pounds and is designed to deliver both conventional and nuclear warheads. The missile is designed to take out high-value targets. Its low-altitude flight capability will help it avoid radar detection, while its high-targeting precision allows it to strike critical infrastructure in difficult terrains. The ETLDHCM will eventually be enabled for launch from land, sea, or air platforms. It is to be noted here that the missile is not operational. Development and validations are still ongoing. The system is supposed to undergo several more rounds of testing. Hypersonic capabilities mark a strategic leap. The combination of speed and extended reach enhances India's strike range. The missile builds on the success of the Hypersonic Technology Demonstrator Vehicle, HSTDV, tested in 2020 and follows the November 2024 trial of the long-range anti-ship missile, LRASHM, another hypersonic system under Project Vishnu. Only a few countries apart from India have hypersonic weapon technology till now, which includes the US, Russia, and China. India is stepping up efforts to modernize and future-proof its defense capabilities as China and Turkey deepen their strategic partnership with traditional enemy Pakistan. ETLDHCM surpasses the range and velocity of India's existing BrahMos cruise missile, marking a significant advancement in indigenous strike capability. Compared to BrahMos's Mach 3 speed, its speed of Mach 8 is way higher. The kinetic energy alone will be very destructive. BrahMos, with a Mach 3 speed, is known to break ships in half in several tests. Its range of 1,500 kilometers also marks a jump from BrahMos's original 290 kilometers, which was later extended to around 450 kilometers and further to 800 kilometers. India's aim with the ETLDHCM is to strengthen its deterrence strategy, particularly in relation to China. With this missile, it will be able to strike deep inside China and in an anti-ship role will restrict its growing influence in the Indo-Pacific. It will be interesting to see how long it takes to deploy the missile operationally.